This is experiment 12. The pre-lab review page is in front of us. Experiment 12 deals with acids, bases, salts, and buffers. Question number one looks at safety alerts. Look for the triangle icons. Number two, the disposal directions. Look for garbage can icons. Several questions here, not too bad. What observation is used in Part E to compare the buffering ability of various buffers? pH measurements are used. Let's have a look at the data and report pages. In Part A, you're looking at acid-base neutralization. And the data table asks for the appearance of the solid residue, result of adding silver nitrate. Typically, when you make observations in chemistry, you look for colors, you look for the formations of solids or precipitates. So those are the things, the descriptive kinds of words that the grader will look for. Part B deals with pH measurement. And it's okay if you need to use a pH range, for example, 8 to 9 or 10 to 11, because as you look at these pH values, some of them will be a little hard to differentiate. So ranges are okay. Part C deals with acid-base indicators. I've got a number of indicators over here on the left. They're substances that change color depending upon whether they're in acid or in base. The ideal indicator gives you two distinct colors. And some of these work better than others for these particular acids and bases. Over here in the report page is where you select an indicator that showed distinct color difference in acid and base. And there might be a couple of good ones, but you only need to enter one, so you wouldn't have to list them all. Part D is the behavior of salts in solution. And you'll be measuring pHs. And again, if you needed to, you could record a pH range. Boil distilled water down here. Usually it's 6 rather than 7. If it's freshly distilled water, it might be 7. But as water sits around a little bit, it absorbs carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. That lowers its pH just a little. And you'll be comparing these pHs to the pH of distilled water at 6. And here in the report page, it asks now for salts that had pH higher than water. So in other words, above 6, pH lower than water, below 6, and those that have little effect, well, they would be very close to 6. And then here's a fun part, a little bit of a challenge for you, but it's fun. Ions exhibiting significant Bronsted acid characteristics. In other words, in those salts that we just looked at, some of these ions will lower the pH. And here, they're ions that will raise the pH. And then in this last blank, there are ions that exhibit no significant acid-base characteristics. I would recommend that you identify these first, because that'll help you. Let's go back up to this table just a minute. And so, for example, if you decided that sodium chloride, perhaps, gave a pH that was around 6, that means that the chloride ion and the sodium ion have no acid-base characteristics. And if you apply that now to the sodium carbonate, say that sodium carbonate did give a pH different than 6, either acidic or basic, it wasn't because of the sodium ion. So that's why I would go through and I would decide which ions do not give acid-base characteristics, and that'll help you as you fill in these first two spots right here. I'm sorry, these two spots. Let's look at part E. Here we're looking at buffers. Buffer, you know, is a solution that resists a change in pH. Ranges are okay. You're measuring pH values. You'll have an initial pH. You'll add some acid and again measure the pH. You'll add base and measure the pH. And a buffer would be one that resists a change in pH as you add acid or base. And that's where you use this information right here when you come to the report. And that brings us to the questions at the end. There are several of these. One I want to help you with just a bit, because it deals with amino acids. And amino acids may be a little foreign to you at this point. Here's the structure of an amino acid. It's a covalent molecule. And it asks us to circle the response that represents buffering action against added base and draw a square around the response that represents buffering against added acid. A gets the square, C gets the circle, and then I'll leave it up to you to tell me why. Hey, I hope you enjoy the experiment. Send me an email if I can be of help.